Hello guys, how's it going and welcome to my let's play of Virry VR. And yes, I am using my Elgato Game Capture HD for this. And yeah, I thought I'd try something a bit different for you guys, nice and relaxing gameplay for you. And yeah, just to have a chance to see some wildlife up close and personal. And confession time now, guys. I have never been abroad. Never. I'm nearly 32 now, guys. I'll be 32 this year, and I have never been abroad. So I thought I'd give this a whirl, considering it might be the only chance to get up close and personal with the wildlife. But you never know. I might get out there and visit the vast world in the future. But yeah, I thought I'd give this a whirl for you guys. But you can also check out live cameras that they have set up at some rescue centre. I forgot where it is, but obviously it's abroad. So you can check out the wildlife 24/7. Which is pretty nifty, but we are checking out these, the woodland, river and savannah. So hey guys, I do hope you enjoy. Let's get to it.
Welcome to the forest.
Thank you.
Here we focus on trees and a river rather than on animals.
Whoa.
Please enjoy each space for as long as you like. When you want to move on, look for an icon of a paw print and choose it. To exit and go back to the home page, just press any of these buttons. L1, L2, R1, and R2.
Cool. The size of that tree though. Massive. Oh, this is nice. Wow. Nice and relaxing this. But yeah, I think this section here is more of a relaxation session, really, so you can sit back and relax and just listen to the sounds, you know. But yeah, it's nice. Let's move on. Right. Oh. Bloody hell, that's loud. Yeah. But yeah, the 3D audio looks really well. It really does. Let's go down here. man. Oh, this is nice. Wow, that'd be cool. Just jump off that. Splash. That'd be nice. Oh, this would be nice to just chill. Who's that? I saw you. Did you see that then, guys? Did you see that person behind that rock? I saw you. Yeah, I believe that you can. Oh, look back at the screen then. Savannah. But yeah, there are a few animals that you can interact
now
with
you're in the
now.
Savannah. Look around and see what you can find.
But yeah, like I said, guys, there's a few animals that you can interact with now. And in the near future, they'll add more animals which you can interact with, which would be pretty cool. So, yes, I will be back with another video for this. But let's check out this one.
We've been told there is a young leopard near here. Let's throw down some meat we bought from a butcher.
Okay.
Then maybe the leopard will come and check it out. To throw down the meat, just shake your controller now. Great. So now we just have to wait.
Okay.
While we wait, here's a question for you.
Okay.
How often do leopards eat meat that's been killed by other animals? Do they often eat meat killed by other animals?
Ooh.
Do they only do it rarely, or do they never do it at all? Choose an answer.
It's either never or rarely. What do you think, guys? For me, I think never.
So, you need to make a choice or nothing will happen.
Animal? I'm talking with my fans. I'm gonna go with never.
No, that's not quite right. Oh. Have another go.
Maybe not.
Yes.
Ah,
right.
Okay.
African leopards are primarily hunters, not scavengers. It's rare for them to eat animals they didn't kill themselves. So the leopard probably won't eat our meat. But let's wait and see.
Okie dokie. Oh, hello.
Here's the leopard.
I know. It's right in front of my face. But yeah, they are absolutely beautiful animals. Where are you going?
Doesn't look like the leopard wants it, but she hasn't gone yet. Let's see.
Okay. Just look at those wastelands. Who's coming back? Oh!
Does want it.
Cool. You hear something? What did you hear? Nope. Now you're taking the shed.
It's hard to predict what wild animals will do.
That's true.
And you gave meat to a leopard.
Yeah. You're welcome. Should we try the elephant? Oh, I've got an itch.
We've been told there are some elephants heading this way.
Yep.
One thing
they're over there.
Love to eat is branches from the acacia tree. So let's put some out now. and see what they do. To throw down some branches, just shake your controller now.
Yeah.
Great. So we wait for a bit.
Righto.
And here they are.
Oh, hello.
But will they like our branches? Let's see. Here comes a baby elephant.
I'm surprised they can eat them with those huge thorns on them. I'm surprised they don't mess up with the digestive system. Hello. Okay. Yeah.
So baby was interested in the camera, but not the branches. But what about the baby's mother?
That would go. Hello. Yay, that's it. Cool.
Great. Looks like she loves the branches.
She's smart. Look how she's standing on it so she can grab hold of the branches and pull it off. That's cool. Very smart. Well, look at the thorns on those branches though.
Elephants don't have hands, but they do have something which is like people being left-handed or right-handed. So look at this elephant. What do you think? Which tusk does she use most often? Is she left tusked or right tusked? Or does she use both tusks the same amount?
Oh, she definitely uses the right one, considering it's warm and it's shorter.
Yes, you're right. If you look carefully at the elephant,
you didn't have to pee in front of me, though, girl.
That's because she uses it a lot more often than her left tusk. It's just like a right-handed person uses their right hand more than their left. But with an elephant, the tusk that is used the most gets worn down more quickly, so it's shorter.
It's like you could just reach out and just stroke.
Now, of course, this elephant's tusks are amazing.
Yeah.
But what do you think? On average, how big are the tusks of African elephants today compared with their size 100 years ago? Are they bigger than they were? Or about the same size?
Smaller, I reckon. Do you agree, guys?
Yes, you're right, but there's a tragic reason for that.
Poachers. Bastards. Killing beautiful creatures like this and just selling the tusks for money. Absolute bastards. Such a beautiful animal. I can just sit here and just watch it all day. I really could. Is there any? All the others just eat.
Watch her eat for a little longer, or to go back to the homepage. Just press any of these buttons, L1, L2, R1, and R2.
Where are you going? No, I want to watch. I want to watch. Just look how beautiful they are. Really. Oh, are they gonna baby? Oh. let's go with the lioness.
Near here, there have been sightings of a female lion. So let's throw down some meat we bought from a butcher.
Right.
If we're lucky, the lion might come over and check it out. To throw down the meat, just shake your controller now. So now we have to wait. While we do, here's a question for you.
Okay.
How far has the number of lions in Africa fallen in the last 20 years?
Ooh.
Has it fallen by 10%, by 30%, or by 60%?
60?
No, it's not that much. Have another go.
Well, you never know. 30.
Yes, I'm afraid you're right. The number of lions in Africa has
fallen by
30% in the last 20 years. But there are still some left. And here's one right now. Now let's see if the meat you threw down will bring her over.
Hello? Hey. It's like she just right there. Fuck. Got all those flies. What? Good. Oh shit. Yeah. Oh fuck. Hey. Oh, fuck. Ah! Oh, it's she's trying to eat me. Cheeky thing. You got meat there? Eat the meat. Smack, smack. Eat the meat. Yeah, over there. No, the meat. The meat. If I stroke you, come on. Oh, shit.
Great. Yeah. So the meat you threw down was interesting enough to bring the lion over.
Yeah.
She probably didn't eat it because it was butcher's meat and it was just too strange. Never mind. It won't be wasted. Hyenas will eat it tonight. And you give meat to a lion.
Hey. Bye. Look at her, it's like she was right here, right there, and just trying to eat me. I was trying to hyena.
These are the remains of a zebra that was killed last night by lions. All that's left of it now are skin, bones, and a tiny bit of meat. Now, which animal would actually be able to eat all these scraps? Well, look around to your right and see who's coming.
Oh, hello. Hey, oh. Hello. Okay. Wow. Looks like it's been in a bit of a scrap as well, considering it's missing an ear.
Now, what do you think? Which of these animals has the most powerful bite? A lion, a hyena, or a tiger? Pick an answer.
What do you think, guys? Oh, that's a tough one. I'm gonna go hyena.
Yes, you're right.
Really?
A hyena like this has the strongest bite of any mammal in the world.
No, wow.
Her bite is 8 times more powerful than a human bite.
Shit. Human bites can be painful. But bloody hell. The
power of her jaw means that she can easily break and chew the bones of this zebra.
Oh, I wouldn't want to be bitten by a hyena.
She has an incredible digestive system, so she can actually digest the zebra's bones.
Bloody hell.
She's the ultimate recycler. She can eat practically every part of this zebra, including skin, hooves, hair, and teeth. Now even she can't actually digest its hair and teeth, but she'll still eat them.
Fair enough.
You can see that this hyena has lost her right ear.
Aww.
This may well have happened fighting another hyena, because they're very competitive and fight a lot. Now, what do you think?
Okay.
With hyenas, which gender is bigger and stronger? Is it males or females, or are they both about the same? Choose an answer.
It's gotta be females. Definitely. Females, no matter if you're human or animal, females are the strongest. Hands down. And if all you fellas disagree with me on that, then you are just gullible.
Sorry, you need to.
You are fooling yourself. Shut up. I'm trying to talk to my fans and viewers. We are females, definitely.
Yes, you're right.
See?
Female hyenas like this one are bigger than males and dominate them. But the females still compete ruthlessly with each other. Now she's going to take the food away before any rival can get it from her.
Fair enough. She'll be back.
Soon the remains of that zebra will be completely gone. And you got close to a hyena.
Bloody hell, wow. Strong. Oh, bloody hell. Right, I think that's it for this section, guys, so let's go back. Later. Woodland, isn't it?
Now you're in woodland. Look around and see what you can find.
Oh, baby rhino. Zebra. Big rhino. A monkey. No monkey. Let's go monkeys.
Near here is a group of vervet monkeys. Let's see if we can get their attention by dropping a slice of watermelon.
Okay.
To find out, just shake your controller now. Good.
Cool.
We wait for a bit.
Ow.
And here's a female vervet monkey starting to eat the watermelon.
Yeah.
But behind her is a big male vervet. Let's see how this turns out.
Yeah. DIY.
Individual male vervets often dominate individual females. But in this case, the female still managed to take off with half
its tail. Boing.
Now, what do you think? How do vervet monkeys get along with their fellow primates, the baboons?
Ooh.
Do they peacefully coexist? Do baboons attack vervets? Or do both species attack each other?
I think baboons are more vicious, aren't they? So, go with baboons.
Yes, that's right. Baboons attack vervet monkeys and eat them.
Eat them?
But vervet's treatment by humans
Seriously?
Is much more of a problem. Farmers often persecute vervets for being pests, and the land vervets live on is being taken by human development. that vervets are quick, clever, and adaptable.
Where did that other monkey go?
Despite of their challenges, they are not endangered. And these two vervet monkeys have had a great day because you gave them some watermelon. And look,
oh, it's there.
The females got the watermelon back.
Cool. Let's try the big rhino.
This is Nicky. He's a 5-year-old black rhino, and he loves mud baths.
Hello, Nicky. Thanks.
Now, as you see, Nicky has a magnificent horn. In most countries, it's illegal to buy or sell rhino horn. But in some places, you can still get it, if you've got the money. So what do you do?
Stroke it.
How much would it cost to buy a rhino horn like Nicky's? $10,000, $100,000, or $200,000? Choose the one you think is right.
Yeah, it's got to be 200, definitely.
Yes, incredibly, you're right. In parts of East Asia, so poaching is a constant threat. But Nicky here lives in a wildlife reserve with armed guards, so he's well protected.
Good.
Now, he's having a
Stop it. I struck you. Yes. Good boy. Yes. Oh, those flies. Now, bye bye, Nicky. That was cool. Let's go with the zebra or zebra.
This is a group of Grevy's zebras.
Grevy's.
50 years ago, there were about 15,000 of them in the wild. Now, well, what do you think? How many wild Grevy's zebras are there now? Less than 1,000? Less than 3,000? Or about 15,000?
Wow. 3?
Yes, I'm afraid you're right. There are now less than 3,000 wild Grevy's zebras left. They're threatened by loss of their natural habitat and by human hunting. And of course, zebras have plenty of natural predators.
Staring at me.
So they've evolved to be shy and to run at any sign of trouble. Let's see how close this zebra will come to us.
Hello. Oh, it's alright. Come on. Oh, it looks absolutely gorgeous. Hello. Yes. Oh, sorry.
It was good while it lasted. And of course, zebras will also run when they're in groups.
Yeah.
Soon, you'll see these zebras notice that there's a lion in the swamp behind them.
Okay. Righto. That one's cool. Oh, here we go. Wait. Okay.
Zebras need to be shy to survive.
Is that a truck?
You got close to a zebra.
Like a truck. Zebra, let's go to baby rhino.
This is a one-year-old baby rhino named Kitui.
Okay.
It's a kind of plant called alfalfa. So let's drop some on the ground.
Hello, Kitui.
And we'll see if he wants to eat it.
Oh.
To give Kitui the food, just shake your controller up and down now. Very good. Let's wait for a bit.
Thank you.
Here comes Kitui.
Yeah.
Kitui's mother wasn't able to raise him, and so now he's looked after by people. That's why he's used to people giving him food like this. But as he grows up, he will start to live completely wild, like other rhinos.
You're cutie, Kitui.
Now, Kitui is a kind of rhino called a black rhino. So, what do you think? How many black rhinos are there now compared with 50 years ago? Are there twice as many, half as many, or only 10% as many?
Oh, 10%?
Yes, I'm sorry to say, but you're right. 50 years ago, there were more than 60,000 black rhinos.
Oh.
Now it's under 6,000. But Kitui lives in a well-protected conservation area.
Good.
So there's a good chance he'll have a long life.
Good.
And he's having a great day today because you gave him his favourite food.
Aww. Hi, Kitui. Oh, it's such a shame. Let's go back. Well, there you have it, guys. That was part one of Virry VR. But yeah, it is a shame that there are less animals in this world, you know, considering with all these poachers, you bastards, killing all these wonderful creatures, you know, and just selling parts of them for money. Absolutely ridiculous. So yeah, I do want to give high praise to all these people who risk their lives to protect their animals, you know. It really does mean a lot for me personally, you know, considering I absolutely love animals, you know. And yeah, it would be pretty cool to get up close and personal with the wildlife, you know, like these guys do who protect them, you know, just to maybe feed them and stuff. It would be pretty cool. It would be a really cool experience to do in real life. But yeah, this is probably the closest I'll ever get to doing it. So, but yeah, I hope you enjoy this part of VVVR. And yeah, in the near future, when the game gets updated with more animals, we shall be back and experience that again, guys. So yeah, for now, guys, I do hope you enjoyed, so feel free to like, comment, share, and subscribe to help me out a lot. So dispatch it as, and I'll see you soon with a new video.